following program is intended for mature audiences.
What's up, everybody? Ike here again. I'm in Hall River, North Carolina, and I haven't got my truck fixed yet, so it's all raggedy going down the road. So you'll see me in the next week or so. You'll probably see me in a raggedy Butler truck, 7713. Anyways, so that's the reason why I haven't got to do any good productive videos. Instead, I've been having to just kind of hang on to this thing. What's been going on? Well, not much. Just been driving around. I got to take a load close to the house, and so I got to spend the night at the house here a couple days ago, which was nice. I figured I'd do a good question and answer video, because I've got a lot of questions out there about various different things, and I haven't got a chance to really sit down and do this yet. I'm gonna be here for probably a 34-hour restart here. Anyways, all right. I've got a question about fuel mileage. My fuel mileage in my last truck here at Butler was about 7.2 miles per gallon, and that's pretty good. Figuring that I pretty much always haul heavy loads. I mean, right there at 80,000 pounds. Couple of things that help make that a good number. One thing, we have APUs on this truck, or on all these trucks. We're at least, I've seen some without them, and if you see a Butler truck that's a white International, I don't think those have APUs on those. But so my idling time is down. There's no idling time. And you figure those APUs cut out so much fuel. If you idle your regular engine, your motor, on the truck for 10 hours, you're going to be burning 10 gallons. It's a gallon an hour with one of these big motors. Now, if you take the APU, which is a little motor on the back of the cab that run heating, AC, and power, where it charges up your batteries and everything, you can go 10 hours and use it a gallon. That's it. So, definitely that makes up a lot of cash. Not for me, but Mr. Butler, of course. Anyways, and that really trickles down to company, where if we're all saving money, it's all going to come down and affect our our billfold. So if we're all saving money for helping, that's when raises and bonuses come in. All right, also that helps out on my fuel mileage is our trailers have trailer fairings, which I will show you in another video when I don't have this kind of junky truck, and I could get a trailer with one of those fairings, or a couple of those fairings. But you'll see them going down the road. They're pretty new. They haven't started doing that in the last couple of years, so they're pretty cool. And then the rest is me. I mean, I use what they call progressive shifting, and maybe in a video in the future, for some of you non-truck drivers out there who don't know what progressive shifting is compared to regular shifting, I'll show you how I do it. And I'm not on the gas all the time. I don't have to run up against the governor. And if I go a couple miles slower than 65, if I could do 63, my life is actually a lot better. When I come up to somebody who is, I'm kind of going at the same speed, like a JB Hunt or a Swift, I have that extra firepower to get around them faster. Whether if I'm sitting there stuck at 65 and I come up on a Warner truck, and it's a lot easier that way, and it's saving fuel. All right, another question is that I did make a mistake on my Trucker Cribs video. On this air suspension gauge, I said the word drives and I meant to say the word steers. And I looked back on the video and sure enough, and there it was. I was like, no, I meant, you know, it was steers, not drives. And, no, you said drives. So yeah, it was definitely steers or drives, whatever. See, I'm all confused.
Shut up, dummy.
You know, we have a certain amount of weight that we're allowed on each set of axles. Our steer axles, which is up front, is we're allowed 12,000 pounds. I believe that's right. Mine usually goes 12,080. So that means I need to lose some weight. If I lost 80 pounds, which I can lose 80 pounds, I have that much to lose, I could be legal up there, but no one's messed with me. Now, on our, we call these our drives, that is, you know, you can just think of drives as, you know, it's driving us down the road. That's where, you know, there's a first set of axles that are doubled up. So, that are attached to the truck. That are on the truck. Yeah, something. Those are called our drives, and when we go to a CAT scale, we try to make those below 34,000 pounds. 34 is the limit. And same with our trailer axles. We call those our tandems. And those you can move around. You can move those, and I'll show y'all in another video how we do that, how we move those for some of you non-truckers out there. And I do have, for you truckers out there, I do have an audience that are non-truckers. You know, some of them are quite good friends of mine. So I kind of cater to them a lot more than what I do a lot of truckers, because a lot of this, you know, trucker stuff, trucker lingo that we have, you know, is going over their head. So I'm trying to make it simple, but you know, it's hard to, because that's all I've known for how many years now. Anyways, so that's my weight distribution, and I'll show y'all how to how I do that, how everyone else does it. Another question that was out there is about me. I have a couple, like where I'm from and what my CB handle is and all that. Well, I'm from Lake Whitney, Texas, and if some of y'all out there across the country don't know where that's at, it's in between, I like to say in between Waco and Fort Worth. It's closer to Waco. It's about 30 miles north of Waco. That's where I'm at, right off 35. You know, a lot of you know where Hillsboro, Texas. That's about 10 miles to the west of Hillsboro, Texas, so that's where I'm at. My CB handle is Mighty Waddy. It's something that I did not name myself that, so don't pull a race card out on me. There was a Mexican fella that was a friend of mine that I worked with that we always kind of went back and forth. We always talked a lot of trash to each other, and we talked so much trash, you know, we came up with nicknames with each other, and he called me Mighty Waddy, and it stuck. I've kind of leaned away from that handle just because there's some that take offense to it for some reason. So if you ever hear me out there go by the word Big Country, that'd be me too, I guess. I don't know. I always use Mighty Waddy, but just depends on who my CB audience is. I'll say Big Country if I think I may offend somebody. It doesn't matter to me. My name is Ike, and that's another question out there that someone wanted to know what my YouTube name is, why it's KE5WDP. Well, that's my ham call. I'm a ham radio operator. When I started my YouTube account, that was my user sign-in name, so just stuck with that. And I like being known by that. Hams have pride in their ham call. And I've often thought about getting a vanity call where you could actually change it to whatever you want to, but I sign in to all these different websites as KE5WDP, and then if I changed it, I wouldn't be KE5WDP no more, and I'd have to change everything. And I'm quite proud of whatever I've posted here on YouTube or various websites. So I'm just going to keep it like it is. Someone asked me where Butler Transports, where we run. We run, west of the Rockies or east of the Rockies. I've heard drivers going out to Salt Lake City in California, but those are very rare runs. They're rare runs for me because I haven't done them, and I've been here for 2 months. And I've pretty much stayed east of the Rockies, mainly south of I-80. I have done north of I-80 a couple times, but I was back down south of it again, and mainly north of 20, but I've had runs south of 20, so like to Laredo. So, but mainly those are our main runs, running areas, rectangle thing. And I've heard the drivers going up to Maine, Massachusetts, and all that. And so get with me on Butler Transport if you're interested. Minimum time out is 2 weeks, and that's something I don't like, but I'll get used to it, I guess, for a little while at least. I tell you, to be totally honest, I do not plan to stick with my whole career here at Butler, just for the fact that I need home time. I do have kids at the house. I have 11-year-old daughter, Rebecca, and I have a 6-year-old daughter, Kristen, and I do want to see them grow up, and I do want to be a part of their lives. So I believe this OTR thing relatively temporary thing until I get my feet on the ground and probably get something a little bit more local. I will get to some of those other questions, but those are some of the main questions that have been out there asked by a couple of different people. So still, this truck has not been fixed. I haven't been through Kansas City. I was supposed to go. I was supposed to be rerouted. So if you see this truck out there on the road, you'll see 7713 on it. It's got part of the bumper missing. I didn't do it. Another driver did it. Dagum mirror hanging on just barely. It's a trashy truck. And so if you see me going down the next couple weeks, holler at me on the radio. Mighty Whitey, Big Country, IKE5WDP. Hey, ugly looking bald headed dude. Holler at me, and I'll talk with you on the radio. Anyways, that's all I got, man. 73, and we'll get some more productive videos instead of looking at my ugly face, all right? So maybe next time I'll have something more productive. All right, 73. Enjoyed it.